First off, I want to thank you all for coming and watching my video. And I am Newbie007, and let's get started today. First thing you're going to want to do is open your GPS. You do that by hitting Shift 2 on most airplanes. On all standard airplanes with FSX, I believe it is Shift 2 or Shift 3, depending on what airplane you're flying. And the first thing you guys would want to note is the runway heading, you know, because that's kind of important, because you don't want to come in, you want to come in on the runway straight. You don't want to be off to the left or off to the right. If you want to start, you want to preferably start where there is two runways right next to each other. That gives you a greater probability of landing on one of them. So you're going to want to minimize your GPS, slide it over, click on the top, and click on the side. Go ahead and minimize it, and we're good to go. Okay, now that we're already here on the runway, let's go ahead and request takeoff from tower. Newbie 007, calling tower. Are we cleared to take off from runway 6 right?
Newbie 007, clear for takeoff runway 6.
Thank you very much. See you later. By hitting Shift Zulu, 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 you can bring up this airport, or this aircraft information rather, in the upper left-hand corner of your screen. It tells you everything from your airspeed to your altitude to how many G's you're pulling. The number that you want to keep your eye on is the altitude. It's about in the middle here on the upper row. This aircraft information is very handy when you can't really tell sometimes whether you're going up or down, but that altitude indicator really helps you out there. And you can look up in the right, in the upper corner there, and when that altitude number starts to reach about 8,000, then you're going to want to start making a turn to your left or right, depending on which one is more convenient for you. I like turning left. Remember, as you continue turning, remember to keep ascending. Eventually, the clouds will have to stop at some altitude. You want to try to note the altitude at which the clouds stop so you can prepare for landing. Now that we're well above the clouds here, and we're about halfway down the runway here, or halfway back to the airport, we're about parallel with the runway here. You just want to make sure your heading is parallel to the original takeoff heading. You can do that by checking the green lines and your current position of your aircraft on your GPS. Now that you have a little downtime up here, you might want to spend a little time just checking out the scenery. Sometimes if you're in, like, the Rocky Mountains or the Alps or anywhere mountainous, you can see the mountains poking up around the clouds. So just take down your GPS, get rid of your flight information up at the top there, and, you know, just enjoy the scenery for a while. Okay, now that you're a good ways past the airport, go ahead and start turning the same direction you originally turned, and start to descend. Start your 180-degree turn and descent to the runway here. I wish you the best of luck on your landings. As you continue to descend, make sure when you come out straight that your heading is the same as the runway heading that you recorded at the beginning of the movie, at the beginning of your flight, actually, not my movie, haha. And so yeah, just make sure it's the same when you come in, or else you'll come in at an angle and that's the last thing you want on the landing. As you start to come in where the green lines are on your GPS, that's like the approach where you want to be when you land. And that's a good place to start preparing for landing, putting down your gear, lowering the flaps. If needed, put out the speed brakes, you know. Get ready for land. Remember, if your airport has those green lines on your GPS, remember, always follow those instead of the blue runways or, you know, the purple runway or whatever in your GPS. Always follow the green lines because they are right. Now, as you see the runway coming into sight, go ahead and close down your GPS and close all the aircraft information up at the top there and just focus on that landing. And now it's about time that we request clearance to land. This is Newbie 007, calling tower, requesting landing, runway 6 left.
Newbie 007, you're cleared to land, runway 6 left.
Thank you very much. And as you come into land, it's basically just like any other landing. Make it smooth, calm, and connected.
Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done.
Okay, thank you for watching. Oh, by the way, if you know how to use ILS, this whole video has been a waste of your time. Sorry. Goodbye. See you next time.
Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry.